The big shot here was a little crybaby, all right.
Yes, yes.
Used to pee in his bed.
Okay, Dad.
We just need to scare the fangs out of the kid.
Hair hangs?
Character effects for an animated feature can be comprised of many different things. It can be muscles, skin, hair, or cloth simulation on any given character. And on Hotel Transylvania 2, it encompasses all of that.
One of our biggest challenges on the show with cloth especially is the fact that the body proportions are not remaining, you know, constant through the shot. So a good example is Johnny. Johnny will have broad shoulders and then narrow shoulders. So if we build a garment for him that fits the broad shoulders, when he goes narrow shoulders, it wants to fall off his body. So we had to develop systems of like, how do we hedge our bet along the way in a shot to rescale the base garment to the animation performance so that it'll want to stay on the body. We also sometimes had a blend back and forth between what Anim was doing with, say, Drax Cape and how we wanted to add our performance in terms in cloth sim. You know, one of the things we're always like, well, you just use our silhouette and add wrinkles, but that's not really how cloth works. So what we would do most of the time is try to find a particular silhouette line that we wanted to hold and then allow the rest of the garment to do what it's supposed to so you would get flow and wrinkles.
In a particular shot in Hotel Transylvania 2, Johnny is performing Kung Fu. If a real human was to move this way, opposing from frame to frame as quickly as Johnny was, not only would they break their arms, but they would tear through their clothes. So in order to make things simpler on the cloth simulation side, what we do is we'd break up the shot into chunks where the character is moving semi-realistically, where our solver could handle that, and then stitch each piece back together to make it one congruent shot. Dennis and John are dancing together in the finale, and they're doing kind of like this disco-y, you know, hand wave thing. And in order for some of the characters to do that, their appendages needed to be longer. So what we do is we take the resulting scale that animation is taking to make the hands longer, to get the noodly shapes that they want, and then we plug those new scales into our cloth simulation to essentially stretch with the character. Genndy likes to design his characters sometimes on a shot-by-shot basis. Even though we'll start off with an initial design, on a generic character like a zombie, you may want 50 different variations of a zombie if you're showing them all together in a single sequence. So it's very common from time to time for us to get completely new designs of non-proportionate scaled or proportionate scaled characters in much different shapes than we originally planned for. So we came up with a way of taking the initial design and then the animator's new design, or Genndy's design of the character in the shot, plugging in the new scales, taking those shapes, and then plugging them into our simulation before at the first frame of the shot, so when it simulates, we have a new proper scale. Without doing this, if you have a character that's, say, my size, and you make me 2 feet shorter, and you make me 2 feet wider, Mike, I'll look like I'm wearing potato sacks, and which was the case with our zombies without this technique.
Right, Johnny?
Oh, hey, dude man, it's not me, it's maybe. Hey, dude man, I'm afraid to say anything. Hey, dude man, I'm a dude man.
Drac?